guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Isha and I hope you all are staying safe and staying happy in your homes. So in the previous videos, we have seen the important question and answers for the chapter Fundamental Unit of Life. With that, we have completed the first chapter of biology, that is from NCERT, that is the chapter 5 we have completed. So the next chapter which we are going to see is about diversity in living organisms. This is one of the important chapters as well in biology. So it is little bit tough, but I will make it very easy for you guys. So yeah, if you haven't subscribed my channel till now, so please do subscribe to it. Hit that bell icon so that you will get a notification whenever I upload a new video on YouTube. So yeah, today we'll start with diversity in living organisms, NCERT biology for class 9. So yeah, let's get started. Now, what is diversity? What does that mean? Now, diversity means the state of being diverse, or there is a variety of organisms being very diverse about it. So it is very variety of organisms are present. Now, similarly, there is a word known as biodiversity. Like biodiversity means variety of plant, animal life in the world or in a particular habitat. Now, what does this biodiversity mean? Is there is a variety of plant and animal life in a particular habitat, or you can say in all over the world. Now, what does this bio mean? Bio means life and the diversity means variability. Now, what is living? Living, we are going to see each and every word, that is diversity and living organisms. Hum ek ek word ka meaning janenge usse pehle. Living means the things which are made up of cells and are capable of carrying out various cellular activities. Now, what does living means? That what it is made up of cells and capable of carrying out cellular activities. Now, there are different features that describe the living. जो लिविंग को डिस्क्राइब करते हैं वो कुछ फीचर्स है दैट लाइक ग्रोथ वी ग्रो रिप्रोडक्शन इज बीन सीन इन एवरी ऑर्गेनिजम्स मेटाबॉलिज्म इज ऑल्सो बीन सीन सेलुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड कॉन्शियसनेस नाउ दीज आर डिफरेंट फीचर्स दैट डिस्क्राइब द लिविंग नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी ईच एंड एवरी वन वॉट डज दैट मीन नेक्स्ट वी हैव वॉट इज ऑर्गेनिजम्स Now, what does organisms mean? It is an individual, it means an individual animal or a plant or microorganisms or single cells life form. It is known as organisms. Now, as I told you, there are different features that it describes that we are living, describes the living. The first one is growth. Now, what does this growth mean? It means that it is usually defined as the increase in mass and number of individual organisms. Now, humans, they grow up to certain age, but there are some cells or some organisms, they replace the old ones. Cells, they keep on dividing, and the new cells, they keep replacing the old ones. Even some non-living organisms, they show growth. They also grow, but they grow in the sense that they due to the accumulation of particles on net. For example, there is a growth of mountain. As the snow falls on water, the accumulation happens, the growth of mountain is also being seen. So the basic way we can say what is growth is that increase in mass and number of individual organisms. It is seen in living as well as the non-living things, non-living organisms. Next, we have the reproduction. Now, it is a process, reproduction, it is a process by which an organism produces an individual like its own. There are two types of reproduction, that is sexual and asexual. It is being seen in each and every organism. Next is metabolism. What is metabolism? It is something which comprises where all the chemical reactions going inside a human body or a living cell or a living body, it occurs. All the chemical reactions which occur in a human body or a living cell, that is known as metabolism. Next, we have a cellular organization. Cellular organization, it means that all the organisms are made up of cells. Now, as they follow an organization of cells followed by tissues and then organs, and they turn and it combines to form organ system, then further organ system, they together form an organism. As we have seen in the previous chapter, that cells, from cells we can see tissues, and tissues say organ system say organism. So this is the cellular organization. Next is consciousness. What is consciousness? Now, it is a property by which an organism reacts to an external stimulus or change in environment. Now, this, it has an ability to sense any change in their environment. This is the consciousness. We are conscious about what is changing around us, what has been happening around us, that is external stimulus to the plants or change in environment to the animals. So this is the consciousness. Now, so these were the five properties, these were the five features, that is growth, reproduction, metabolism, cellular organization and consciousness, which describe that it is living, we are living. Now, next we have, that is, each organism is different from all others to a lesser or a great extent. Now, for example, you and your friend, you are, something is similar between you both, but if you compare yourself with a monkey, there are some common things, but if you compare yourself with a cow, there is nothing similar, but you would say that monkey is more common than cow to us. So this is a way that each organism is different from all organisms, or it is lesser or greater to an extent, it is different from every organism, whether it be a microorganism or an aquatic or a aerial body, anything, let it be any organism. Now, in similar way, there are many organisms or different forms of life which are present on Earth. There are many life forms which is present on Earth. Now, we can see there is microscopic organisms like bacteria. It is very, very small. And on the other hand, we can see blue whale, which is a very huge, approximate 30 meters. And in plants, we can see that redwood trees, they are, which is found in California, it is approximately 100 meters. It is very huge. So in this way, we can see many things which is very different forms of life is present on Earth. Now, next is the pine trees. They live for thousands of years. This is also one of the characteristics, that pine trees, they live for thousands of years, while the mosquitoes or some insects, they die within a week or a few days. So even this is something different. This is also different, which is present on our Earth. Now, life also changes. It also ranges from a colorless worms to a brightly and a colorful organisms, flowers, which are present on the Earth, which is present on an Earth system. We can say there are brightly colored birds and flowers which are present, or we can see the colorless worms which are also present. So you can see here pictures that we have a bird, a lion, flowers, aquatic, humans, everything. It is very colorful. We can see on our Earth, we can see everything. They are very wonderful diversity we have. Now, we have such a wonderful diversity of all living organisms, whether it be plants, animals, or microorganisms. Now, there are very different variety of life which is around us, that has evolved on Earth over millions of years ago. Now, we are going to see everything about it, about each and every organism. Now, we don't have that much time that we can see to each organism, but we can see the similarities. With those similarities, we are going to group the organisms and we are going to know about them. So because of this, we are going to make a relevant groups to study the variety of life forms. As we can't study each an organism, but there are few similarities between organisms. With that, we are going to see, we are going to differentiate it. And yeah, with this, I'll end up this video here. This was a little intro about what we are going to see in further videos. We are also going to see in the next video, that is the basis of classification. Then comes the classification and evolution. and further the animal kingdom, plant kingdom, many other things are there. So this is a very huge chapter, little bit tough, but yeah, we'll make it simple. We'll study together and we'll make it simple. So yeah, that's all for today. Next video we are going to see these topics, classification and evolution, and the next is basis of classification. So yeah, thank you for now. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed till now. Share and please do like the videos. Likes bahut hi kamate hai. Please do like the videos. Comment on my videos what you want to see, whatever you have questions.